One question is designed to give subscribers valuable insights on how executive leaders in college athletics think about key issues on their respective campuses, in their departments, or within their leagues and conferences.
Greetings, this is Ty Brown, and welcome to One Question, where we highlight executive leaders in college athletics. Our guest today is Coach Grant Teaff. Coach Teaff served as the head football coach at Baylor University for 22 years. He was the executive director at the American Football Coaches Association, I think for 22 years also, Coach. And you've done a number of things in terms of leadership, a number of things in terms of influence, and I really appreciate that you're here with us today.
Ty, I'm happy to be with you today.
Well, I want to talk to you about a couple things, Coach. First, you know, I end this podcast, every time I do one, I end it with the words, be better tomorrow than you are today. And that's something I got from working with you for almost 15 years there at the American Football Coaches Association. I really like the people who are listening to understand where that came from, why that was important to you in your role as a head football coach, and also in your leadership role as the executive director of the AFCA when it comes to leadership and influence.
It stemmed, Ty, from a very early age for me. It was a conclusion that I came to that served me well, both as an individual and then as a coach. But basically what I developed was the concept that I didn't have the talents and abilities of some other people that I was competing with my own age as I grew up, but I felt like I could improve. If I worked, I could improve in whatever I did. I wasn't the fastest, but I worked and improved and found ways to take a shorter route to my target, i.e. as a linebacker to a opposing running back. So every day I said to myself at an early age, you know, if I can just get a little bit better in this or that or whatever I was focusing on each day, then I would be better tomorrow than I am today. It's the concept of never stop improving. Never think you're where you need to be. The best of the very best can get better. There is something in their life that they can improve on. There's something in their mental approach to life that they can improve on. And there are physical things that you can still improve on. But sometimes athletes will reach the maximum as far as the physical is concerned, but they're nowhere near the maximum mentally. So be better tomorrow than you are today. In every phase of your life, man is physical, he is mental, and he is spiritual. So the focus on improving every day in those areas will make you better tomorrow than you are today.
All right. It makes sense, Coach. I watched you do it for those 13 or 14 years I worked for you at the AFCA. But of course, I was too young to see you do it when you were at Baylor. I wonder, when you took over at Baylor, you won Southwest Conference championships. Tell me how you applied that philosophy through your 22-year tenure there at Baylor University.
You know, Ty, that's a really great question, because one looks at a certain area of success and think, oh my, it just happened right then and there. But preparation is everything. For me, I basically had prepared my whole life to take on the Baylor job. Folks probably don't remember, because it's been a good while ago, when I took over, Baylor had won like two or three games in 47 or 48 games. They were deeply at the bottom of the Southwest Conference totem pole, without any question. They had no facilities. Their stadium that they played and practiced in didn't have a blade of grass. They didn't have a weight room. There was no academic support whatsoever. So it wasn't just at the bottom of the football ladder. It was at the bottom of all the ladders that are important for a student athlete to grow. I virtually had no intentions of taking the job at Baylor, but it was just for me. A lot of people won't understand this, but this is what you could say. It was meant to be for me, it was just a God thing. That's where I felt like God wanted me to give my life. And so Donnell and I, my wife, we just happily did that. But what I was able to do is apply the same principles to building success that I had in my own life with a desire to be a head coach in the Southwest Conference. Ty was a little kid from Snyder, Texas. I'd seen the television, early television, where you would see a Southwest Conference team play. And so I just set my goal to be a coach in the Southwest Conference. As a matter of fact, and you've probably read this, we've been together so long, but when I graduated from high school, the annual college annual, or the high school annual, I had a, you know, what everybody was going to end up doing, prediction, you know, prophecy, so to speak. And they had me coaching at the University of Texas because everybody, all my peers, knew that my goal was to be a head coach in the Southwest Conference. Texas was the biggest, baddest thing around. So I guess whoever wrote that in the annual just assumed that that's where I'd be the head coach. But I missed it 90 miles, which isn't too bad. Became the head coach in the Southwest Conference at Baylor, and it has been and continues to be, even to this day, an amazing experience. And so that's basically, to cap up the question, a better tomorrow than you are today. I look at that in every phase of my life. You know, when I'd never given a speech. I wanted to be a person that could communicate, first of all, with my players if I was going to coach, but secondly, then to communicate things to those that had a desire and an interest to know. So I never took a speech course. I picked out people that I liked to hear, Ty, that touched me in their speaking. And I would go over to the library and get a record of their talks or their speeches that they were made. And so from that, I determined what they were doing and how they were connecting to people. So I set about with my own concept. And basically, I'm a guy that paints word pictures so that people can see the action that I'm talking about in their mind or the example that I'm giving. And so it has served me well in the area of communication. But that is an example of starting from zero and finding a way to get better each and every day as to what you're attempting to do. In that case, it was the ability to communicate and to communicate to groups. Ty, one of the things that makes that so good for me was that when I came into Baylor, it was at the bottom of the totem pole, no facilities, and so I had to go out, and I spoke in the first 2 years, I spoke to right at 150 high schools across the state of Texas in the first 2 years at their banquets or at graduation, wherever they would invite me, I would go. And that did two things. It established who I was, and then it also made individuals out there feel possibly this is a guy I'd like to have to be my coach. So when they became juniors and seniors, then we were able to recruit some really, really good football players.
Right, right. What's impressive about that, coach, is you come into a situation and sound like you started when you were young, like you said, and you identify where you want to be. So then you methodically figure out how to be better tomorrow than you are today, how to slowly but surely get to where you want to go. It's very interesting thing.
That is exactly what it was, Ty. And I think that's if there's a message that we could get out that coaches, teachers, administrators could get across to their young people, you don't have to be the best tomorrow. You know, you can just count on being better tomorrow. And then someday you'll be the best. If you just think about the number of days in a year, just think how much improvement you could make if you concentrate on being better tomorrow than you are today in whatever area you want to be better in. Is it reading a book? Is it studying history? Is it developing ways and means of teaching physical development or speed or whatever it might be?
When you retired from Baylor, you spent a couple years in administration there at Baylor, and then you took over at the American Football Coaches Association. And one of the first things you introduced there was professionalism. And from my understanding, right, I wasn't around yet, but from my understanding, it was if we want the rest of the athletics and academic world to take us serious as football coaches, then we have to carry ourselves as professionals. And there's an aspect of being better tomorrow than you are today in that, too. Tell me about how you implemented that throughout your years as the executive director of the American Football Coaches Association.
Well, again, Ty, that's a very important question because it can be applied to everybody that's listening in their own way. But when I took over, I hate to say this, but it was really more of a kind of a big family get together and beer bust. And there was not a great amount of emphasis placed on education. There weren't a lot of coaches that would go in and listen to the speakers. They were out, you know, socializing, that type of thing. And so it just, it was really gnawed at me that here's the opportunity for every one of these coaches, whether they're high school, college. You served our association for all those years, so you know about conventions better than anybody. But the opportunity that we tried to provide them was exactly, you know, what we've been talking about. If they could come in and hear somebody that's been there and done that and learn a way to be better themselves, then just look at the improvement that they can teach to those under them. So that was really the basic concept of education. Not that somebody would come in and talk about how great they were, how glorified they had been through their coaching profession, but how did you do it? What were the techniques that you used? What was the mentality? What were you able to convince your team to become through how? What action? So, you know, it was a very important thing for me, and I believe very strongly that the American Football Coaches Association has one of the most unique opportunities in the world because basically we give advanced education to those that are educating thousands of our young people across America. They happen to be doing it on an athletic field or a football field in our case, but they are educating. Everything that is taught in the practice or on the football field is a part of a child's development and their education. Yes, you get the academic aspects of it in the classroom, but that which we are teaching as coaches on that football field that we work on, whether it's practice or game, you know, we have the opportunity to educate young people about the real important aspects of life. Education is so important, but how you personally develop yourself, the attitude that you take, the willingness to give total effort in everything you do. And I think, you know, one of the most important things that a child can learn through athletics is to have self-discipline and self-control. So many people destroy themselves because they have no self-discipline or no self-control. And of course, the last thing that I think coaches should teach, and all of this by example, you know, if you don't live, Ty, what you teach, then it is invalid. And so therefore, you know, if you're going to teach the importance and power of love, a coach must be a type person that can love those young people that they're coaching. Whether it's you're coaching track or baseball or whatever it is, you have the great opportunity to show that you really care. And through that, they can develop in themselves this concept of, yes, I can care about something and it can make a difference in my life, but more importantly, it can make a difference in somebody else's life.
Right, right, exactly. So give great effort, have discipline in your effort and your work ethic, and then make sure you care about what it is you're doing and who it is you're affecting. Coach, those are excellent.
Yeah, there's no question about it. And it's wonderful to see somebody grasp those concepts and look at them 10, 15 years later, which I've lived long enough to be able to do. It's so pleasing and gratifying. Just makes you smile.
Well, Coach, I'll wrap with this. As you know, I think that the influence you had on the football coaching profession and coaching profession in general, to where people took it seriously and started carrying themselves different and wearing ties and carrying themselves as executives, as leaders of football program, I think that was an inflection point in college football, an inflection point in high school football, to where people started respecting coaches more than they did before. And I'll say this about the game of football, and this may be my opinion, but I think that the game of football is the reason why there are still sports in high schools around the country. There may be a couple, two or three layers to that, but the nature of the game, I think, is the reason why there are still sports in the country. And when you think about academics, football is a sport that between the ages of 13 and 22, for the most part, you have to be enrolled in an academic institution to play it. And that's why I love the game so much.
Yeah, I agree with you, Ty. And I also believe that that's one of the things that coaches, educators, administrators have to realize is that, without question, the development of a child academically is so important to their future. But they're learning to take care of their physical bodies. They're learning to compete and to develop within themselves that never give up attitude that you can basically get from sports, no matter how good you are. You don't have to be the starter. You can be the last place guy on any team. But if you have it in your heart to compete every day, to develop that constant attitude that I am not going to give up, I am not going to quit, I will do what it takes to ultimately win. And that, in a nutshell, is basically what it's about, Ty. It's about teaching young people those very important principles of success in life.
Yes, sir. Well, Coach Taft, this has been an excellent conversation. I really appreciate you joining me here on One Question.
Ty, thank you. It's so good to be with you. I miss you a lot, and we spent a lot of years together, and you were deeply a part of any success we achieved at the American Football Coach Association in my years there, and I thank you for it.
Well, I really appreciate that, Coach. That was Coach Grant Taff. He was formerly the executive director at the American Football Coaches Association. Of course, he spent a long time as the head coach at Baylor. He's pointed out three things that are important for leadership and important to be successful in life, which is give great effort, make sure you have discipline in the effort you give, and also care about what you're doing. And of course, this is Ty Brown with One Question. And keep in mind, the role of a leader is to create and maintain an environment that people want to be a part of. And as always, be better tomorrow than you are today. This episode of One Question is produced by Spades Media Group, solving problems using creative leadership.